macOS Mojave Beta 10 is now released. Is it better than the Beta 9? And when we talk about bugs, are they still there or are they all gone? So if you want to know everything, stay tuned after the intro. Hi everyone, welcome to MacPack, where we unpack your next problem. And hey, if it's your first time here, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. On this channel we only talk about technology, so if you like this type of content, I hope to see you in the next one. On this video we are going to talk about the macOS Mojave Beta 10, which performance that you can find on Geekbench and Cinebench, and I will compare with the macOS Mojave Beta 9. So let's talk about the performance that I get with my MacBook Pro. So this is a MacBook Pro mid 2012. I know it's not one of the last computers that you'll find on the market, but my main objective is to let you know if I'm having better results when I pass from one beta to the other, and that's why I have to compare with the computer that I have here. And everyone have a different computer. Maybe you have an iMac, maybe you have a MacBook Pro 15-inch, 13-inch, so every single person will have different results. So let's jump on the performance and see what I get with this new version of the macOS Mojave Beta. So when we talk about Geekbench in OpenCL, you can see an improvement between the macOS Mojave Beta 9 and the macOS Mojave Beta 10. So the score that I get with the macOS Mojave Beta 9 is 6,199, and with the Beta 10, 6,414. So we can see here an improvement of 3.4%. In single score, it's almost the same. So basically with the macOS Mojave Beta 9, I get a score of 3,488, and with the macOS Mojave Beta 10, I get a score of 3,499. So when we talk about results, I get an improvement of 0.1%. So it's basically the same. So when we talk about multi-score, it's basically the same, so the results are very similar. So when we talk about the macOS Mojave Beta 9, I get a score of 11,928, but when we talk about the macOS Mojave Beta 10, I get a score of 11,964. So here you can see an improvement of 0.3%. so like I said before, it's very similar, as the single score is basically the same. So when we talk about Cinebench in OpenGL, the results that I get with the macOS Mojave Beta 9 was 49.42 frames per second, the second test 49.06 frames per second, and the last one 49.29 frames per second, that give us an average of 48.59 frames per second. When we talk about the macOS Mojave Beta 10, I get a result of 49.53 frames per second, the second one 48.30 frames per second, and the last one 47.69 frames per second, that give us an average of 48.50. So here is the only results that will be negative in 0.2%. So it's very similar, but it's a negative result compared to the macOS Mojave Beta 9. So when we talk about CPU in Cinebench, the results that I get with the macOS Mojave Beta 9 was 537, 531, and 533, that give us an average of 534 CBs. When we talk about the macOS Mojave Beta 10, the results was 545, 548, and the last one 548 once again, that gives us an average of 547 CBs, and I get an improvement of 2.4%. Basically with the macOS Mojave Beta 10 you have the same results, but you can see an improvement in Geekbench in OpenCL and in CPU when we talk about Cinebench. So when we talk about bugs and improvements with the macOS Mojave Beta 10, I don't have anything to show you guys. So the bugs that you find on the macOS Mojave Beta 5, 6, 7, 8, they continue there. The improvements that you will find on the macOS Mojave Beta 10 is exactly the same since the Beta 5. So if you want to know all the improvements they have done, I recommend you to see the videos that I've done about the macOS Mojave since the episode 5, so since the macOS Mojave Beta 5. So I'll leave in the cards above me and in the description below. But besides the performance, unfortunately I don't have anything new to show you with the macOS Mojave Beta 10. Question of the day: what you think about the results that I get in Geekbench and Cinebench with my MacBook Pro mid 2012 with 8GB of RAM? Let me know in the comments below. Before you go, don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you don't have subscribed until now, share this video with your family and friends, comment below, smash the thumbs up, and like I said in all my videos, you already know the answer. I see you in the next one!